A fable, a myth, a story written by Bennett Schneider during the Great Station Fire in Los Angeles in 2009. The Two Mountains. Once there were two spirits of nature, a brother and a sister. The brother's name was Gabriel, and the sister was named Catalina. Each was so pure of heart, and so innocent, and so beautiful, that they were loved by the gods and goddesses. Gabriel became the lover of Zeus, and Catalina was beloved by Poseidon. So great was the love of each god that they bestowed upon the brother and sister a boon. They made them into mountains. Zeus set Gabriel high up on the land that he might visit his lover often. Zeus rode to Gabriel in chariots of white and gray clouds, and their lovemaking was so intense that the land around them moved. Catalina rose up from Poseidon's ocean, her head and shoulders sticking out of the sea, while her lover caressed her and surrounded her, always embracing her. Catalina could see Gabriel across the bay and called to him. "Gabriel, proud brother, how is it with you high up on the land?" Gabriel replied, "Catalina, you should see what I can see. I am so high that Zeus, the king of the gods, wraps my shoulders in a white mantle. Truly, I have become great." It was true. Zeus had made Gabriel the greatest mountain in the land, where Gabriel coated himself in tall, gorgeous redwood pines, bejeweled with amber-covered cones. Catalina wore modest bushes and scrub oak. She called to him again over the rivers and valleys and small hills. "Brother, how is it with you?" "Sister, the finest deer prance upon my slopes. I have both igneous and metamorphic rock formations, and my springs are popular with people from all over the earth." Catalina had only pigs and summer campers on her slopes, but she was beloved by Poseidon, who caressed her every day. She was content. Now, it must be known that Zeus is a randy god with many lovers in many places, and he is hard-pressed for time to please them all with his lust. So he saw less and less of Gabriel. He saw so much less of him that the land behind Gabriel dried up for lack of Zeus's rain and turned to desert. Catalina called to Gabriel, "Brother, how is it with you? Do you miss your Zeus? Do you long for his love?" Gabriel replied, "No, my sister, I hardly pay attention to that old man anymore. If he has other fools to flatter his ego, what do I care? I am a great mountain, nearly a god myself. People below come to worship me. They tell stories by their fires and name gods who they tell live in my slopes and caves. Holy men and women make pilgrimages to me to meditate on my shoulders. Truly, I am as great as Zeus." Catalina called back, "Be careful, brother. If the gods hear your words and your hubris, they will be displeased." Gabriel shouted loudly, "Let them hear! Zeus has no more love for me. He has left me alone. Alone! Alone! And in his absence, I have become a god." Catalina worried as the waters of her lover around her grew dark. Gabriel's words were indeed heard by the gods, and Hera, the wife of unfaithful Zeus, heard them most clearly of all. This upstart believes himself a god. He was not satisfied with my husband's passions, but now wants his place. It falls to me, then, to humble him. And she sent Hephaestus, the god of fire, and Zephyr, the god of the wind, to torment Gabriel. The two gods were cruel, and they burned and raged over Gabriel. They started low and jumped and ran up his slopes. They crowned his peak and in flames and smoke and laughed in his face. Ha! There you go! There's your crown, greatest of gods! Gabriel screamed and begged as the two tore off his beautiful green coat of pines and amber-covered cones. His form was now dwarfed in size by the huge cloud of smoke and ash rising from his own burning. Catalina, seeing everything across the bay, wept, her tears running down into her lover's waters. Poseidon rose up and asked, with her tears in his hand, "Why have you returned these to me?" Catalina told Poseidon exactly what had happened, and the sea god beheld the torture of Gabriel. He said to Catalina, "Sweet mountain in the sea, you are always good and stay with me. For your love, I will help your brother, because I see you two love each other." And he sank into the waters. 5 days and 5 nights Hephaestus raked Gabriel, while Zephyr ran the searing flames for miles around and around Gabriel. The rivers boiled off his skin, and the noble deer died in the flames or ran off. Gabriel's face was black with soot and shame. On the 6th day, Poseidon whispered to Catalina, "Brace yourself, sweet one. I have found a wild woman of the sea. She is dangerous and powerful, and she will save your brother." And it was as he said. Hymena was her name. And she was cloud gray and black, with swirling white hair and lightning fingernails. She loved to dance, and Poseidon had offered her a place to dance wildly. Hymena swept up from the south and spied Gabriel from the column of smoke above him. She careened into the land, sweeping waves over Catalina and washing the pigs on her into the sea. Hymena slammed into Gabriel and spun and jumped and whipped her hair about him. Hephaestus could not burn her nor Zephyr blow her away. Her wild pleasure knew no limits. And though she raked her lightning across Gabriel's face, and though her rains washed away his skin, she stopped the burning. Eventually, Hymena's energy was too fierce and too great and could not stay in one place alone, and she moved on, leaving Gabriel quiet again. Catalina thanked her lover and called out to her brother, "Gabriel, how now?" Gabriel replied, "Catalina, I have been great, but not so great as others. I have known love and care, and I forgot. I hope I will know them again. But for now, sister, I will simply offer a place for trees to grow tall and green dear to Rome, and silent people to sit in my caves and contemplate their lives. Hearing his words, the gods were pleased, and Apollo, gorgeous, perfect, sexy Apollo, rode in his golden chariot over Gabriel and shone down.